using AI tools such as GPTs helps build equity in higher education, period. They are amazing tools. They are not the only thing that helps build equity, but they are a piece of that puzzle that we're working towards. And think for a second, if different people, different minds, different people's minds can process text differently than others. For example, people who have dyslexia, they take more time and effort to go through and read something, right? So it takes more effort. And when people put more effort, why wouldn't we want to give them a tool that could help with them to really absorb and take in all of this amazing content? Because when they take in this amazing content, they're able to utilize what we're teaching them in creative ways to solve complex issues. And that's what we want. So let's take a look. Read this paragraph. It will take you a lot of effort in order to read this paragraph. But if I put it into my favorite GPT and say, can you help? Can you explain this to me? Not only does it explain the content, which it does here, so it gives me a new perspective, it also gives me the ability to hit the magic speaker button so it speaks it to me as well. So now I have more ways to absorb this information, to take this information in. So that's why really using all of these tools are a matter of equity, and it's a matter of really being radically student-centered. So if you're on the fence, I hope that this little example helped you bring you over to the side of using these tools. Of course, we have to use them in a way that's ethical, and of course, we have to build them in a way that's ethical as well. But we need to be able to go through this and learn how to use these tools well so we can be completely and radically student-centered to help learners of all types.